10 Amazing Worlds Lost on Earth. Hey everyone, welcome back to another unbelievable video from Mind Read. We're so happy you could be with us today. In this video, we're gonna take a look at the top 10 amazing worlds lost on Earth. Whoa, what a super cool topic. Do you know of any? We'd love to hear your thoughts in the comment section down below. And don't forget to add the real or supposed locality too if it hasn't been located yet. We're super excited to get stuck into these amazing worlds, and we know this is going to be mystical and very interesting. So, without any more waiting, let's see our top 10 and stay tuned for our best pick at spot number 2. Here we go! Number 10. At our 10th spot, we can tell you that the Mariana Trench in the Western Pacific takes this place in our countdown. The Mariana Trench is one of the deepest locations on Earth and has only been visited on 4 occasions. The trench is 1,580 miles long and about 43 miles deep, and it contains a host of strange organisms that scientists know very little about. Measuring the greatest depths in the Mariana Trench is an exceedingly difficult task, given the technical challenges of delivering instrumentation to such a remote location and then getting accurate readings. The first attempt was made in 1875 during the Challenger expedition, 1872 to 1876, when a sounding of 26,850 feet was obtained near the southern end of the trench. In 1957, during the International Geophysical Year, the Soviet research ship Vidyaz founded a new world record depth of 36,056 feet in Challenger Deep. In addition, another deep hole, which was first called HMRG Deep, which stood for Hawaii Mapping Research Group and later renamed Sirena Deep, is situated in south of Guam and east of Challenger Deep. First encountered in 1997, its full depth has been reported variously as 34,911 feet and 35,463 feet. Number 9. At spot number 9 in the countdown, we have this footage of this amazing lost world. Sima Humboldt and Sima Martel, Venezuela. Sima Humboldt and Sima Martel are two gigantic sinkholes located at the top of an 11,500-foot mountain in Venezuela. Originally discovered in 1961, a lot is still unknown about the deep and dark depths of the sinkholes, with one which is so massive it has its own ecosystem at the bottom of it. Wow. According to local legend, the sinkhole is a mysterious and an evil place. The bigger sinkhole is located on the summit of the plateau of Sarisari Nyametepui in Bolivar State. It is unusual for several reasons, including its enormous size and depth, and its location on the top of the only forested tepui, having a patch of forest at its base, being due to the weathering process that formed the sinkhole in the said origination. The feature is named after scientist and explorer Alexander von Humboldt. Together with the neighboring Sima Martel, it was first spotted in 1961 by a pilot who discovered it by mistake. Its volume is 640 million cubic feet, with a maximum width of 1,155 feet at its upper rim. Number 8. At the 8th spot, we can tell you that this amazing place makes up the next part of our countdown. This is Melville Range, located in Australia. In 2013, scientists discovered this remote rainforest in Australia. It is located on a giant boulder plateau on Cape York Peninsula, and is only accessible by helicopter. Wow! Many strange, never-before-seen species call this oasis their home, such as the leaf-tailed gecko. National Geographic photographer Tim Lehman led the Cape York Biodiversity Expedition and became exceedingly interested by Hoskins' descriptions of Cape Melville, and teamed up with Hoskin for this expedition, which was funded by the National Geographic Expeditions Council. Here, the team set out to study the rainforest and its inhabitants, which have not largely been studied by science. The 9-mile-long range is almost impassable, surrounded by a fortress of chunks of granite that have eroded in place after being thrust up through the earth millions and millions of years ago. Hoskin called it a crazy adventure. This one takes our 8th spot in the countdown today. Number 7. Spot 7 goes to this footage of Palawan Highlands, located in the gorgeous and inspirational country, the Philippines. Here, botanists were exploring a remote area of Palawan Island when they discovered a carnivorous plant at the top of Mount Victoria and Mount Sagapa, which makes up part of the essence of mystery and craziness of this place. The hungry flower is so large that it unbelievably feeds on rodents and even small monkeys to survive. Other mysterious forms of life were also discovered here, but have yet to be identified within their full spectrum for scientific placements. As of 2016, the main island of Palawan was rated the most beautiful island in the world, as voted by the readers of rival travel publications Condé Nast Traveler and Travel Plus Leisure. El Nido, located at the northern tip of the island, is also currently rated the most beautiful beach in the world by Condé Nast Traveler readers. In 2007, the National Geographic Traveler magazine rated Palawan the best national destination in East and Southeast Asia region, having incredibly beautiful natural seascapes and landscapes, one of the most biodiverse terrestrial and marine islands in the Philippines. They went on to say, "The island has a biosphere reserve status since the early 1990s, showing local interest for conservation and sustainable development." Number 6. At the 6th spot in the countdown, we're super stoked to show you the Bosavi Crater, located in the very beautiful Papua New Guinea. 200,000 years ago, the cone of this volcano caved in, falling a whopping 3,000 feet into what is now an isolated ecosystem. In 2009, a BBC documentary crew filmed a trip into the crater, where they quickly discovered 40 previously unknown species. Nobody lives in the crater or on the surrounding slopes, but north from the mountain, there are four groups of native people: Kaluli, Ologo, Walulu, and Wisesi, all speaking in non-Austronesian languages. Here, the ground is covered with a wet carpet of moss. Diverse climatic conditions led to high diversity of plants and animal species, and on Mount Bosavi, this diversity is very high. Here lives numerous birds of paradise, including a vast array of exotic orchids. And this takes our number 6 spot in the countdown for amazing lost worlds on Earth. Number 5. At number 5, we have this amazing footage of Mobile Cave in Romania. This cave near Mangala was found quite recently, in 1986, when workers building a geothermal power station dug down. It had been completely sealed off for 5.5 million years before that time. And despite the lack of light and oxygen, a groundwater ecosystem had adapted to the toxic conditions, spawning translucent, mutant insects. The air in the cave is very different from the outer atmosphere, in fact, and the level of oxygen is only a third to half of the concentration found in the usual open-air atmosphere. The cave is known to contain 48 species, among them leeches, spiders, and a type of unique water scorpion. The food chain is based on chemosynthesis in the form of methane and sulfur-oxidizing bacteria, which in turn release nutrients for fungi and other bacterium. While animals have lived in the cave for around 5.5 million years, not all of them have arrived simultaneously. The most recent animal recorded is the cave's only species of snail, which has inhabited the cave for more than 2 million years. That's mind-blowing, really. Number 4. At spot number 4, we're super excited to show you this lost world, Socotra Island. If you ever feel like visiting a completely different planet type place, then look no further. Located in Yemen, this island has been isolated from mainland Africa for the last 6 or 7 million years. Because of this long period of mostly isolation from hordes of people, the island is home to about 700 extremely rare species, one-third of which are endemic, meaning they can only be found there and nowhere else on Earth. The island is also home to the dragon tree, whose bark's resin is called dragon's blood, and it's prized around the Mediterranean for its medicinal properties. The island's climate is known as harsh, but even in such high heat and dry air, the most amazing plants really can thrive. Socotra is unlike anywhere else, a zoological and botanical treasure trove, and a refuge for unique species that died out long ago in other places. The island also holds a large number of cave systems that have yet to be explored, with some stretching up to 4.3 miles in length. Even though it's geographically isolated from the world, it is populated by humans, although they themselves are very isolated from the rest of Yemen. Number 3. In our countdown, the 3rd spot goes to Atlantis. Now, you've probably heard of this one in a kids' movie and generally on social media or in articles and legends too. Atlantis, a likely mythical island nation mentioned in the philosopher Plato's dialogues, Timaeus and Critias, have been the piece de resistance of fascination among Western philosophers and historians for nearly 2,400 years. Plato actually described it as a powerful and advanced kingdom that sank in one night and one day into the ocean around 9600 BC. The ancient Greeks were divided as to whether Plato's theory was to be taken as history or mere metaphor. Plato's Atlantis is said to be an island larger than Libya and Asia Minor put together, and located in the Atlantic just beyond the Pillars of Hercules, which is assumed to mean the Strait of Gibraltar. Its culture was advanced and it had a constitution exceptionally similar to the one outlined in Plato's Republic. It was protected by the god known as Poseidon, who made his son Atlas the king and namesake of the island and the ocean that surrounded it. As the Atlanteans grew powerful, their ethics declined. Their armies eventually overthrew Africa as far as Egypt, and also led Europe as far as Tyrrhenia, or Italy, before being driven back by an Athenian-led alliance. Later, by way of divine punishment, the island was beset by earthquakes and floods and sank into a muddy sea, swallowed up for its evil doings. Number 2. Here's our best pick, sent in to us by Charlie Davidson from Silicon Valley. 2.2 million years ago, this massive mountain formed on the border of Guyana, Brazil, and Venezuela. It depicts Mount Roraima, an amazingly stunning, almost floating looking landscape that is much like what is depicted in the movie Avatar. This plateau is found in beautiful South America, with the highest point reaching just over 9,200 feet. Natives of the savanna see this exceptional plateau as a mighty tree stump, which used to grow and hold all the fruits and vegetables known to man. These Venezuelans believe the history of the place to be surrounded by good fortune and know it to be very auspicious, a gift from Mother Nature herself, as the folklore suggests. The tree was said to be knocked down by Macunaíma, the trickster in the tale, and as the tree fell to the ground, it released a magnanimous flood which led to life. The steepness of the plateau makes it almost impossible to climb, but there has been a route deemed for climbers as the best path for ascension if they choose to take it on. The most beautiful part of Mount Roraima is the feeling that it's floating high up in the clouds. It's a photographer's dream, and a definite bucket list for climbers who seek a true and unyielding challenge. Thanks so much, Charlie. This best pick of the day is truly awe-inspiring, and we really do love it. Number 1. We made it, everyone! The number 1 spot is finally here! Are you ready to discover this amazing lost world? It's Song Dong Cave in Vietnam. This expansive cave remains largely undiscovered even now. Locals knew about the Song Dong Cave for a long time, but remained far away in fear of the loud sounds and roars that echoed from it. In 2009, the cave was partially explored for the first time though. Turns out it's the biggest cave ever discovered, with ceilings that span to reach 500 feet up and walkways that boast a whopping 650 feet in width. The cave is so big that it has its own inner forest, expansive rivers, and its own weather system too. From an early age, local man Ho Khan used to spend weeks on end trekking and maneuvering his way through the jungles of the Phong Nha Ke Bang National Park, searching for food and timber to earn a modest income. In 1990, Ho Khan stumbled upon an opening in a limestone cliff and moved forward to investigate it further. As he approached, he noticed clouds billowing out of the entrance and could hear the sounds of a river raging somewhere inside of the cave. When he could feel a strong wind also blowing out of the cave, he decided to move on without further inspection because he felt unsure of it. By the time he had returned to his home a few days later, he had forgotten its exact location and thought no more of it. At the same time, two members of the British Cave Research Association, Howard and Deb Limbert, were basing themselves in Phong Nha to conduct exploratory cave expeditions in the area. And this takes our number one spot in our countdown here today. We're so glad you could join us here today at Mind Read. In fact, we'd love to hear something from you in the comments section below this video. What was your favorite in the countdown? Where would you like to venture to? What other amazing lost worlds do you know of? We certainly enjoy reading all of our viewers' comments, and we're super stoked that you could join us today from wherever you live in this amazing and very beautiful world. Until next time, we love you, and we'll see you real soon. Stay healthy and happy, peeps!